Muchos niños de 13, 14 años y dejan de estudiar y día a día la gente se va y dejan de estudiar. Muchos chicos. Y es muy triste ver a los niños a esa edad ir a trabajar, pero sería más triste porque si no se van a trabajar van a morir de hambre. Es la realidad. Así mismo es acá y todo aquí. En esta parte de Paraguay.
The mission of the school is to educate the most dedicated and most economically disadvantaged kids in Tobati. Our hope is to fund several projects at the Institute, some of which include new whiteboards, new tables, school supplies, update our current computer lab, and to start a college fund for our students.
Each student receives a full academic scholarship to study, eats three meals a day, and is given full medical health care. In addition, he receives school supplies and various transportation costs.
Teaching here, it's a really good experience from the point of view that students feel more encouraged to learn, they're more willing to participate.
When I was little, I had this dream, I wanted to study at the U.S. And back then, I didn't thought that that could be real. I couldn't get it, but when I got into the Institute, I thought that, well, I can go to study in the U.S. It could be possible.
Entrar al instituto se logró una pequeña parte de mi sueño, porque gracias a este colegio seré alguien en mi vida y para mi familia y para todo mi país también. Y el instituto me apoyará mucho porque vengo de una familia humilde.
My dream is to study medicine. I would like to be a doctor.
Today, I can proudly say that I'm a Mock School alumnus and first-year student at the University of Pennsylvania.
Our hope in making the video is that those of you at home can start to see a little bit of the reality of our students here at the Institute. A little bit really does go a long way, and trust us when we say that, we really do need the help.
I really thank the people who help us to achieve our dreams.
I just want to give this thing to the people that helped us and nothing else.
Thank you very much. that, ladies and gentlemen, is why we are all here tonight. So yeah, round of applause for doing a good thing. That, of course, is only partially the reason why we're all here tonight. I'm also here, and they'll be singing as well. So it's great. If you have not been here before, you're in for a real treat. So welcome, everybody, to the second annual YAF. Second annual to me hosting it, which is really all that matters. So this is my second time being here. So round of applause for that, because that's pretty amazing. Yeah. I never do things twice, so this is a one-time only thing for us. If you were lucky enough to be here last year, or you watched the live feed broadcast around the world in the comfort of your jammy pants, to literally kajillions of people, then you know what a treat you are in for tonight. Not just because these kids that are gonna sing here, are so talented, enthusiastic, and happy, but again, I am here, right here, okay? And believe it or not, this almost didn't happen. We were that close. When my hapless talent agent, I'm not gonna mention his name right now, was negotiating the terms of my MCing contract, the KO brass, Dennis Biscard, who's here, and other KO brass, just wouldn't budge on some of my, I thought were very reasonable demands for me to host again this year. As you can see out front, there's no red carpet. There's no massage tent, which I requested. I got no manicure or pedi, which I deserve and need. There are no peanut M&Ms in my celebrity trailer. There's no celebrity trailer, none of it. It's empty, there's nothing. I got nothing. I got a bottle of water. Why would I do it again, then you ask? Because this is a magical night. And the aforementioned headmaster, Dennis Biscard, told me that if I didn't do it again, he would instruct the dining hall staff to cut me off at one soup bowl on soup bowl day. And I can't have anyone messing with my soup bowl. In reality, this is really the 10th annual YF. Okay, let's hear it for 10 years. That's amazing. In reality, this is probably gonna be the most enjoyable evening of your lives. As already mentioned, I'm here. That's one, okay? And it is a night filled with amazing singing. But it is also a night that will give you the warm fuzzies. And you will leave here reassured that maybe our society is going to be okay in the end after all. Finally, I would be remiss if I didn't remind us that the biggest reason that we are here tonight, and that is to raise money for a great cause, Team Toba Team. And even though we are here for this great cause, this is a competition, a singing competition at that. So in order to help us separate the great singing from the extraordinary singing, we have flown in, first class of course, some of the most prestigious judges from the four corners of the globe. They are in a very particular order of importance. Okay, this first one, college professor, choir director, and vocal performer. They call her Catherine, I have a lot of last names, Swanson Ellis. Where is she? We're not gonna show them? Are we gonna show the judges? Is it just like last year where we don't look at the judges? There they are, there's Catherine. She's a big deal. Filmmaker and member, I love this, of YouTube sensation Backtrack, which I know a lot of people, you are fans of them on YouTube. Mallory, No Poser Moser. Where are you, Mallory? Where are you? There she is. She's all right. She's a pretty good judge. Not too shabby. Oh, this one. He's a big deal. College professor again, great conductor, a cappella adjunctuator, right? I Googled that, right? I thought that was made up. That's a real thing. You have to go to like, you have to be trained like in the hills of the Himalayas to get that to get that title. He did it. Music technician and former member of Boston's pro group, No Strings Attached, Brian, I am probably Irish, O'Connell. Yeah. Am I right, Brian? Are you Irish? Yes, I knew it. Not to be outdone, professional singer, songwriter, and member of, I thought it said Barack's, but it says Backtrack. She's a member of Backtrack. Melissa, cousin of Michael Giordano. She's being very humble, but she's the cat's pajamas. She is. You don't know, you don't even understand who these people are. Former member of Boston's pro group No Strings Attached and Vineyard Sounds, you've got a friend in Brendan Dolan. Where are you, Brendan? Brendan's trying to get the beard. He's not there yet, but he's trying. You keep it up, Brendan. You'll get there one day. So tonight's format, for those of you that have never been to this amazing evening, each of the groups will perform one selection per round. All groups drew lots to determine the performance order. After the intermission, their performance order will change. At the conclusion of round two, there will be a performance by A Minor, one of UConn's co-ed a cappella groups. And during this time, we will also feature our People's Choice Beatbox Battle. That's alliteration. I'm an English teacher, by the way, so this will be littered with English teacher stuff. Three of my students are right here, Ava, Audrey, and my friend Allie. You'll probably hear Audrey talking a lot because she loves to talk. She does, she's super good at it. The beatbox battle, we will have a live audience participation survey where the audience can vote for the beatbox performer they find to be the best. At the end of the battle, the live voting will end and the standings will reveal our winner. To end the evening, we will have an award ceremony recognizing various performers, musicians, and groups. All right, without further ado, we're gonna get to this, okay? We're gonna start right away. This is a great appetizer. We're gonna start with the singing group, Guacamole. Okay, so Guacamole, come out here, please. Let me tell you what they're doing right now as they get set up. Guacamole is probably my favorite name of the night. They are singing a song called Latch. First of all, Guacamole is from Lexington High School, who has three groups here tonight. They were here last year, I remember. They're pretty legit. So you're in for a good start. You don't call yourselves Guacamole and then not be really good at something. So have you ever bought an avocado? They're like $98. So. Right? What's the purpose of that? They're singing a song called Latch, which comes from Sam Smith, somewhere in there. I don't know if it started with him, but somewhere in there Sam Smith touched it. So enjoy.
Close enough. Can I love? held in my embrace, I'm latching onto you. Feel so encaptured, got me wrapped up in your touch. Feel so enamored, hold me tight within your clutch. How do you do it? You got me losing every breath. What did you give me to make my heart beat out of my chest? Now I've got you in my space, I won't let go of you. Got you shackled in my embrace, I'm latching onto you. Now I've got you in my space, I won't let go of you. Got you shackled in my embrace, I'm latching onto you.
Great job, ladies, and we're off and running. That was beautiful. Jocelyn Geller, she was a soloist on that, if you wanted to know. That was beautiful. As expected, Lexington High School, you should be proud. My music teacher, her name was Mrs. Foss, and she wasn't tremendous. She used to ask me to use my quiet voice when singing in the high school choir. She called me a quiet bass, and she stuck me way in the back. And I don't blame her, I wasn't very good. But it got me thinking about my own musical experience growing up and how different it is for these kids. And so I can't really go any further without giving a shout out to the teachers that have made all of this possible. Can we give some love to the teachers, the coaches, the instructors? Because really, when you think about it, I don't like to throw this word around, just toss it around, but we're heroes, right? Like, we're heroes, you know? We are. We're like, who is better than us? Like, firemen, maybe. Firemen, teachers, and then everybody else. Soccer players, maybe. All right, so the next group, we're getting right to it, man. We're not messing around with the schedule. Strawberry Fields is about to come out here. Strawberry Fields, let me tell you about them. They're from Bristol Eastern High School, and I think they're about to bring some Imagine Dragons right into our face right now. So if you're a little older and you don't know who Imagine Dragons are, they are what every middle schooler listens to 99% of their life. So, and high schooler for that matter. So you're about to hear some Imagine Dragons if Strawberry Fields would come out here and give it to us.
Sorry, we're doing Imagine Dragons next.
Oh, that's fine. It's fine. We can wait. We can wait. There's a little teaser. Strawberry Fields always goes for the drama. They did it last year too. So they're gonna switch it on us. So their second number, oh, They're going to undo it. Undo it. That's the name of the next song. So I wish I had undid what I just said. So undo it, which I don't think I know the song, but I'm old, so I might have heard it before. So they're going to be singing Undo It. I'm going to tell you a little more about Mrs. Foss. Is that the worst teacher name too? Like, doesn't that just like encapsulate like your nightmare teacher, Mrs. Foss? Whereas Mr. Chapman, that just spells like pleasant experience. Wouldn't you agree, girls? Pleasant experience. They're nodding or shaking their head no, I'm not sure. But Mrs. Foss, she used to keep me inside for recess. She was my middle school teacher, and so it was like 6th through 8th grade, and we still did recess, or something like that, and make me like look outside and watch the other kids having recess as part of my punishment. Have you ever heard of something like that? It's like totally evil. And like kids now think it's hard. I used to sit there and watch outside and watch, like, and all my friends would be in the window, like, waving to me and, like, playing kickball. That certainly made me want to try harder in chorus, though, so that was a good technique. Where's Strawberry Fields? I feel like they should come out here, right? Are they mad at me because I got the... Maybe they're in makeup, which I didn't have time to do. Do I look okay tonight? This is I call this my winter wedding. I have a summer wedding mode and I have winter wedding. So if you get married in the winter, this is what I wear. All right, here they are. Without further ado, Strawberry Fields.
You made me cry, took the lonely and took me through.
That was amazing. Strawberry Fields. One more time for Strawberry Fields. That was worth the wait. Wow. Wow. I need to tell you about that girl singing that song. Let me see her name. Hannah Wheelock. Wow. Hannah Wheelock. That was amazing. I almost wore those same boots tonight. That would have been totally awkward for both of us, right? She would have worn better than me, but that was amazing. Could you imagine doing that when you were in high school? Like, honestly, like, I was such a mess in high school. I mean, I'm still a mess, but like, high school me was like ridiculous. In fact, funny story, one of my high school classmates I just saw right now before the show. I haven't seen him since high school, and he's sitting like literally right behind me in the show. That's amazing. Was I a mess in high school?
Yeah.
Yeah, you were too, buddy. All right? You were too. All right? You were too. Anyway, we're going to move on. We won't talk too much about our high school experience because my mother-in-law's here again. Where are you, Mama? Where are you, Mama? Where are you? She's out there somewhere. Last year, if you remember, you were here last year. Last year, my mother-in-law was here. Just by happenstance. She's not following me or anything like that. At the intermission, she's like, "Oh, I had no idea you were so funny." Right? And I'm like, "I've been with your daughter for 18 years. You don't know that I'm funny." And she's like, "Well, no, I knew you were funny, but I didn't know you were this funny." And I was like, "Well, I'm a teacher. Look at me. Like, why do you think your daughter is with me? Of course I'm funny, you know? Like, that's all I got, lady. That's it. That's all I'm working with, you know? Why do you think she's sticking around?" Enough about me. We'll get to me a little bit more later. We're waiting. We're going to bring out the 18-wheelers in a second. The 18-wheelers are from the Wheeler School, so very creative name there. Let's hear it for that. And they were here last year, and I forgot to count. I hope there's 18 of them, right? Like, that would have to make sense. So you should count when they come out here if there's 18. As I was walking up, I saw their vans. I don't know if you saw them in the parking lot. They're brand spanking new. I think their school bought them just for this festival. Like, you gotta win this, we're gonna get you new vans. So there's a lot of pressure on them. I hope it works out, or the vans are gone. It's just like a sticker on the side. It says Wheeler School. They can peel it right off and give it to someone else if they blow it. So hopefully they'll get it. They're not here, so I'm gonna tell you a little story. I have a lot of you right now, you're probably here for your high schooler, which I'm super envious of, because I have a seventh grader as my oldest. I have three kids, and currently I have my oldest is a seventh grader. And if you remember what that's like, or you're living that right now, I know I saw some seventh graders out there. Oh, here they come. I'm gonna tell that story afterwards, but I want you to remember what that was like for you. All right, we're in for a colorful treat. They're gonna sing Different. Different by the 18-wheelers.
On your at the start, who knew growing up would be this hard? So hard. The color of your hair changes every week. You know you got a voice, but you're scared to speak. Life just seems like a riddle. You're torn down the middle. Your deeper eyes in a cool way. You always stand out. Don't be afraid. Let go. I see that you're still free. please don't change.
Don't.
All you're looking for today, Dick's a line sign. You don't need all the answers. The only thing that matters, oh, is to let your voice speak from your heart and just be who you are. I love it, your deeper eyes.
Amazing. Great job, 18-wheelers. That was Ben Thornton with that solo. He was in your lap over there. Ben Thornton, he is not shy. Way to go, Ben. That was beautiful, 18-wheelers. You're going to keep those vans. I know it. So a seventh grader, right? She's a daughter, so that's like even worse, right? And I have some. I teach seventh grade, and I saw some of my students out here. So Jordan, Eli, Ellie, don't listen to this. Okay, this is not personal. It's not your fault. But like a seventh grader, like I don't know what happens. Like one day, like my daughter just like she was done. She didn't want to talk to me anymore, and she really didn't want to come out of her room anymore. I don't know what's going on. It's just like locked up in your room, and then you know. She goes to school here, which is a nightmare for her, right? Because she walks down the hallway and then she sees me. And like I envisioned that it was gonna be like, she would run up and hug me and be like, hey dad, I love you, man, I love you. Thanks for everything. Thanks for the electricity and milk this morning. And it's great that you keep doing that. It's amazing. But it's not that at all. It's like, hey, angel of death, why are you looking at me? And she legitimately, like, I call her out on it, right? Because I'm not gonna just let that go. So I started to, like, embarrass her in the, like, cafeteria and hallway, thinking that was a good tact to get her to talk to me more. And it's backfiring. And so she's like, what if we just have, like, a signal? Like, if I just, like, pull on my ear, that's me saying hi to you. And I'm like, or, like, why don't you just say hi to me? You know, like, that could be the signal. Just, like, say hello. But I don't know, like, if I went to middle school with my father, I would probably not say hello to. But I'm not my father, you know? Like, his name's Howard, you know? Like, it's totally different. And he's great and everything, but, like, I'm not him. Like, look at me. Come on. Say hi. But whatever. Whatever. I still have the other two. I have an 8-year-old, but she loves me. And we share a birthday, so like nothing can ever get in the way of that, right? And then I have my son, who's like, he's like, yeah, you're like me, that's awesome. So I'm just strapping everything to those two. One day, like, my seventh grader will become a high schooler, right? And then she'll be awesome again. Like, look at these kids. These kids are awesome. Let's hear it for, like, a high schooler, right? Right? Parents of a high schooler, let us know. Like, it's all easy, right? Once they get to high school, like, everything's, like, it's fine, right? Like, we just gotta wait it out, and then they become human again. So I'm gonna wait for that. No problems once they get to high school. I heard there's like a 38% success rate. Like they turn into human beings again 38% of the time. So that's pretty good. That's better than the seventh grade percent. That's very low. Except for you, Ellie, and Jordan, and Eli. You guys are great. All three of them are in my English class. Also love to talk. All right, so we're next group. Sorry. We're not in my living room, that's right. They actually told me, hey, we're gonna move it along faster this year. And I was like, no, we are not. We are not at all, because you asked me. Pitch Pipes are coming out next. The Pitch Pipes, which are also from Lexington High School. So I don't know how Lexington High School can produce so many amazing singers, what they're putting in the water in Lexington, but they have three groups here tonight, and the Pitch Pipes, look at these guys. This is an all dude group. We're gonna get duded up right now. Look how handsome these boys are. They're handsome and they can sing, so we're in for a good treat. They are gonna sing You Found Me first, okay? So this is Pitch Pipes.
Oh, You got some kind of nerve, taking all I wanted, lost and insecure. You found me.
That was Nate Houston and Pitch Pipes. Yeah. Woo. All right, this is judges. You got a long night ahead of you, man. I don't know how you're gonna do this, but you're really good at judging. So that's what you do. So, speaking of my wife, she is not a good singer. She's a terrible singer, and she's an amazing woman in so many different ways, obviously. But she's a terrible, terrible singer, and so I am too. Like I'm worse than her. But it's really astonishing to me how bad she is, because she is like so good at everything else, and she's like amazingly talented in so many different ways. But and she's beautiful, and like she's like strikingly beautiful, and then she goes to sing and it's just like, it's embarrassing, you know. I'm like, how does that come out, that voice come out of that beautiful face? Like me, you expect that dude cannot sing, right? Like those boys, you knew when they walked out here that they were gonna rip it, right? But she is like, it's a real phenomenon, you know. She and none of us really want to say anything because we love her so much, and we rely on her for everything. So we just kind of look at each other like, you say something. But none of us have yet. Mom, don't tell her that, okay? Wherever you are out there, don't tell her I'm talking about her. I asked her if she wanted to come tonight, and she's like, no, you're going to talk about me, and I don't want to be there for that. So yeah, last year, if you remember, last year I was here by myself in the family row. It was just me, no one was interested. My mother-in-law was here by happenstance. She wasn't supporting me at all. She just happened to be here. But this year I've rented this family right here. This is not my family at all, but I rented them. I found them on Craigslist. Yeah, give my family a round of applause. Good looking family. Here we go. Oh, we are coming to our first Kingswood Oxford group, which is always really exciting. Yeah, yeah. That's home field advantage. Home field advantage right now. This is Crimson Seven, who are ridiculous. Yeah, they're ridiculous. You probably heard about them on the internet and stuff if you're not from Kingswood. But they are amazing. They are going to sing... I don't know if you've ever heard of this song. It's Sweet Caroline. Ava loves that song, so Crimson Seven, you've done well. By Neil Diamond, some guy, Neil Diamond, I'm not sure. This is an amazing song. You're going to hear some solo work from Charlie. And if you've never seen Charlie, yeah, if you've never seen Charlie, you are not going to forget this experience. Yeah, that's what I mean. All right, Crimson Seven.
I can't begin to know as But now I know it's growing strong.
It's growing.
Was in the spring, and spring became summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Look at the night, and it don't seem so lonely. We fill it up with only two. And when I hurt her, it runs off my shoulders. How could I hurt when holding you? Warm, touching. Warm, reaching out, touching me, touching you.
Seven! With their Crimson lead singer, Charlie. That was beautiful. So we're going to bring out our next group, B Sharp. Yeah, West Hartford. Connor High School, West Hartford. Right here in lovely West Hartford. They're going to sing. Well, first, shout out to Rory. Where's Rory's mom? Where's Rory's mom? I met her last night. She was refereeing a basketball game I was at. And she turned around and she's like, oh, I'll see you tomorrow night. And I was like, well, I don't think so. But I'm married. Rory's mom. And she said, oh, no. My son Rory sings for B Sharp. So we're going to see Rory and B Sharp come out here in a minute. They're going to sing Death of a Bachelor, which they coincidentally sang at my wedding, okay? Here we go, B Sharp.
Walking the sky fall.
Be sharp. Be sharp. Guess which one was Rory? Yep. That was him, right in the middle. And Julia. Julia was the other soloist. Yeah, good job. You don't say, hey, I'll see you tomorrow night at my son's concert unless he's singing the solo, right? Like you... That's got to be like the mom of a soloist that says that, right? You should be very proud. Rory was amazing. Thank you, Rory, for that. Okay, we're coming out next with The Grapes. What? The Grapes are last year's champion, so... The reigning champions, they are going to sing two songs about love tonight, which is great because we all need love. And they said the theme of their night is the evolution of love, which I love that, right? That's gorgeous, yeah, it's gorgeous, right? So they're pulling at our heartstrings. Well done, Grapes. Yeah, they're ready. Here they come from Ethel Walker School, Grapes.
Oh.
She told me that I'm not enough. She left me with a broken heart. She fooled me twice, now it's all my fault. She cut too deep, now she left me scarred. Now there's so many thoughts going through my brain, and I'm taking these shots like it's Novocaine.
Of love. That was amazing. Grapes, thank you. The next group we're going to bring out is another West Hartford High School. All high schools group. They're known around the center as a cappella. If you go down to Blueback Square, they talk all about a cappella. They're going to be singing a Paul Simon tune. This is for the old people in here. Yeah, Paul Simon, called The Boxer, okay? For the older people, you probably didn't get any of that just happened right there. This one's for you. A cappella's like, we got to give something for everybody. So they're going to sing that Paul Simon song, The Boxer, which has like all that like la 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 stuff in it. That's all I remember about the song, that he goes la 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 la, which I love. So we're gonna hear some la la la's right now from a cappella.
I'm just a poor boy, though my story's seldom told. I have squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises.
All lies in jest, still a man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest. Mm-hmm.
my family. I was no more than a boy in the company of strangers, in the quiet of a railway station, running scared, laying low, seeking out the poorer quarters where the ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know.
Of Acapella. Yep. That's the only group with their own signature clothing line, which they're selling out in the parking lot after the show, if you want one of those, which I have ordered too already. This is amazing. We are we're a couple groups away from the first round being done, but don't go anywhere, because the last three groups are really impressive as well. We're going to bring out our second KO group. Okay. We got to do a little better than that, because the grapes were really loud when I announced them. Can we do a little better than that? Yeah. We do a little better than that, KO people. This is our girl group, and they're called Oxfordians. And they're going to be here. They come. They're going to be singing just a magical song, which I'm going to tell you all about right now. It's called Turn the Beat Around. And there's a few soloists, Gabby, Remy, and Molly, who all happen to be former English students. So let's pull for them. Okay? Oxfordians.
Bum 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 b
sound, push your sound pretty. Your violins keep moving to the nitty gritty. But when you hear the scratch on the guitar scratching, then you know that rhythm carries all the action.
Turn the beat around. I'd love to hear percussion.
Play your flute, cause I know you wanna get your thing off. But you see, I'm made of my mind about it. Got to be the rhythm, no doubt about it.
The guitar player starts playing with a syncopated rhythm with scratch, scratch, scratch. Makes me wanna move my body, yeah, yeah, yeah. And my drummer starts beating that beat, he nails that beat with a syncopated rhythm with a rat, tat, 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 tat on the drum.
Oxfordians, yeah. I'm not going to be biased, but I'm going to be biased. They're amazing. Like, they're incredible. Like, that was amazing. I actually saw a couple girls from that group at the mall today, the West Farms Mall. Are you familiar with the West Farms Mall? Yeah, it's an amazing place. And I ran into them, and they're like, oh, Mr. Chapman, like, shouldn't you be getting ready for the show? And I was like stuffing my face with those little pretzel bites, you know? Those like butter, like butter sponges. And I'm like, I am getting ready for the show. So it's all working out perfectly. English teacher loves this group. The next group, their name is Onomatopoeia. Yeah. Which is really hard to spell. I don't know if you've ever tried that. It's the first thing they teach you at English teacher school. This is the third group from Lexington High School, and they're about to sing a song called Footprints, and they want to send a shout out, is it John V? Is that who we're going to? Johnny V, you should feel honored right now, because they're singing the song for you, Footprints.
Oh,
I don't know if you deserve that, John B., but Onomatopoeia just sang that for you. So that was amazing. We're bringing out our final group of round one. Their name is Close Harmony. Okay, Close Harmony. We got some Close Harmony fans out there. They've been waiting a long time to hear this. So Close Harmony, let me tell you something about them. I gotta find out something about them first. They're a singing group, first of all. From Fairfield, Ludlow, which I'm not sure where that is, but someone out there knows. In Fairfield, I assume. They're going to sing a song called Shake It Out. And a quick story before they're waving me to shut up. This is so beautiful. And every time I come here and I watch these kids sing, I just remember that there's good things in the world. And I think it's amazing that we're all here supporting them and cheering for them. I went to my sixth graders basketball game today, and the whole time everyone's just yelling, yelling at the kids to run faster and shoot the ball and rebound. And it was like a crazy scene. And like here, all you're doing is cheering for everybody and supporting your kids and loving them up. And that's why I'm gonna tell my kids, sing, man, sing. It's beautiful. Like, don't do that sports thing, it's crazy, right? It's crazy. Not that you can't do both, but if they're like, which one should I do? Of course they have their mother's voice, so it is never gonna happen for them. All right, Close Harmony. No, yeah, here we go, Shake It Out, Close Harmony.
And
close harmony. Her name, I know you're going to want to know her name, is Alexandra Savora. I'm probably saying that wrong. But Alexandra, yes. That was amazing. Beautiful. Beautiful. That brings us to intermission, okay? It's time to stretch your legs. Don't look at the judges. You're not allowed to look at the judges. Don't make eye contact on your way out. But go stretch your legs. It's a 3-hour intermission, and then we'll come back, okay? All right. Great first half. During intermission, I went over there on the other side of the room. This is hanging on Headmaster Dennis Fisgard's seat because apparently he thinks this is the Grammys, right? Like, he's got a placeholder. This is not the Grammys. That's tomorrow night, Dennis. That's not tonight. We're going to take a moment to watch a video about Camp KO. Shameless plug. Here we go. Camp KO. Cue the film. Kids to have an amazing camp experience, get a green t-shirt and be awesome people, you should send them to Camp KO. You can contact Sherry Shea, who's in the house tonight. Sherry, amazing video, great job. We're gonna get started in the second half of our performances. So Phoebe's back there giving me the thumbs up that the grapes are ready. Are you ready for round two of the grapes? Yeah. they come. Here they come. The Grapes are singing another song about love. Their last one kind of made me feel guilty, right? Like I had done something wrong. They were yelling at me. Like I was thinking of all the girls in high school that I had wronged, and I wanted to apologize to them. This one is Best of My Love by the Grapes. Here they are. Trying to win it again. Great. They're trying to win it. They're trying to win it. All right, the next group is Acapella. Acapella. Acapella, you remember them. They're from West Hartford. Yeah. Hall High School. They're going to sing True Colors, which was originally a Cyndi Lauper song, but they told me they're going to sing the Justin Timberlake version, which is very exciting. And Justin Timberlake is performing at the Super Bowl next weekend. Yeah. And I'm going to the Super Bowl, actually. So my father-in-law, my mother-in-law's lovely husband, is taking me to the Super Bowl. I'm not even kidding you. He's taking me to the Super Bowl. Isn't that amazing? Are you happy for me? Yeah. And I realized that everything on my bucket list was because of them. So thank you, Grandma and Grandpa, Mom and Dad. You are checking things off my bucket list, right and left. So I'm going to the Super Bowl, and I'm a huge Patriots fan. Yeah. If you don't like the Patriots, what's wrong with you? I mean, you don't like people that are really good at what they do. You want to cheer for the other guy. Okay. So they're ready. Okay. So Acapella's ready. Here they come with True Colors.
You with the sighs, don't be discouraged or realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all, the darkness inside you can make you feel so small.
The three-quarter zip-ups, but there's nobody cuter than that group, okay? Acapella, man. Woo! That's one collection of cute boys. It might be the zip-ups. They're very nice. The next group is our own. Yep, it's us again, the Oxfordians. They're gonna sing a song that I can totally relate to. It's called Pretty Hurts.
It's a soul that needs a surgery. Mama said, you're a pretty girl. What's in your head? It doesn't matter. Brush your hair. Fix your teeth, what you wear is all that matters. Just another stage, pageant the pain away. This time I'm gonna take the crown without falling down, down, down. Pretty hurts in the light of whatever's worse. Perfection is a disease of a nation. Chest, TV says bigger is better. South Beach, sugar free. Vogue says thinner is better. Just another stage, pageant the pain away. This time I'm gonna take the crown without falling down, down, down.
Ridiculous. Very, very well done, girls. Super proud of you. Oxfordian. Sorry, onomatopoeia is coming next. Those were the Oxfordians from Kingswood Oxford School. And the crazy thing is, they do other things. I was just sitting here thinking, they're students. They're on the head of everything at our school. They're just these are remarkable kids. And I know sometimes as old people, as I am, we get worried about the future, right? We get worried, we're like, oh man, these kids, they never look up. They're just looking down at their phone. Well, where are we going? Where's the world going? I'm here as a teacher, someone around kids all the time, to let you know it's gonna be okay. You know, we are in good hands with these kids up here, okay? The next group, as I said, is Onomatopoeia. They're back, Lexington High School's own Onomatopoeia. They're gonna do, this sounds really fun. They're gonna sing Sweet Dreams and A Little Party Never Killed Nobody mashup. Here we go.
Some of them want to be used by you. Some of them want to be. that you made it. Look around, you don't see one person sitting down. They got drinks in their hands and the room's a bust. At the end of the night, maybe you'll find love. And it's fake chit-chat by the things they got. A must-out reputation, keeping it hot. At the party of the year, I'm the master plan. If you make me realize I'm your man.
Some of them want to use you. Some of them want to get used by you. Some of them want to abuse you. Some of them want to be abused.
It don't mean a thing if I give you my heart, if you tear it apart, no, I. It don't mean a thing if I ain't in your eyes, pop it out, ain't gonna fly.
What's your life like if you're one of those three kids at Lexington High School that is not a good singer, right? That's terrible. How embarrassing. I just want to pause for a moment. They're going to like signal to me, but I'm going to ignore them. I want to honor some people or thank some people tonight, some of the unsung heroes of the evening. Here are some of them right here. Also great children. And up there, Mark Kravitz in the booth has been a wizard with the sound and lights tonight and his crew. It also, Ron, where's Ron? Where's Ron? Ron Garcia. Those of us at KO know Ron Garcia well. He's another hero. He's the man responsible for Team Tobati. He's been taking kids down there for 20 years. This is their 20th year that they've been going, which is amazing. And I've never been on the trip, but I just see the kids when they come back, and it's transformative. You know, traveling is the best thing you can provide for your children, showing them that the world is bigger than the 2 inches in front of their face. And it's really important to do that, and for kids to have that opportunity to go and see that the world is a big place. It's great for it's as important for them as it is for the people in Tobati. So Ron, keep doing it, man. Keep at it. All right, we're gonna move on. Oh no, Close Harmony is back. Here we go, Close Harmony. You remember they closed right before intermission. They brought the house out. Oh, there's Ron. Hold on. We got to honor Ron. Everybody, Ron is one of my own personal heroes. He's lurking in the shadows over there. But he's an amazing man. Here they come. Close Harmony. It looks like another mashup. It doesn't say the word mashup, but I'm guessing. Save the world. Don't you worry, child. This is going to be great. All right, Close Harmony.
Who's gonna save the world tonight? Who's gonna bring you back to life?
don't you worry, child.
Who's gonna save?
Don't you worry, child. Heaven's got a plan for you.
Close harmony. Nicely done. Okay, the next group we're going to bring out right now, we're going to get them right out here, is another Lexington High school group, Guacamole. They're back. They opened the show, if you remember. They're going to sing a song called Price Tag, which, yeah, Ava, I'm with you, girl. Was performed in one of my favorite movies that I watch before every YF as a way to, you know, get in the zone. And that's Pitch Perfect, you know, the original Pitch Perfect. None of that, not two or three, the original, the OG. So are there fans out there? Is it just me? Or yeah, that's a good one. So they're going to come out here and sing Price Tag right now. Here we go. Guacamole. guacamole. Thank you. Okay, side tangent time. Went to the copy machine the other day, found this on top, okay? Percussion, this is a list of percussion instruments, which you're not hearing tonight, obviously, but stay with me. Vibes, woodblock, small triangle, glockenspiel, that's a good one, drum set, timpani, xylophone, splash cymbal, suspended cymbal, vibraphone, maracas, bowed cymbal, kabasa, shakiri, bongos, dumbek, tambourine, finger cymbal, tabla, bells, metal, gyro. Okay? When I was in a middle school, you know what my percussion option was? This. You remember these? The two sticks? If you rushed down to the music room, you could get the ones with the ridges. Do you remember those? And you would go like this. And Mrs. Foss would just tell me in the corner, just stand in the corner and do this, okay? Just be quiet and just do that. Softer, so we can't hear it. All right, sorry. I'm working out my own stuff tonight. All right, oh, if you weren't hungry enough after guacamole, here comes Strawberry Fields, okay? And if you remember, Strawberry Fields, they got really mad at me last time because I announced Believer as their first song, but it wasn't. But guess what? Believer's back. So if you're a fan of Imagine Dragons and Strawberry Fields, here we go.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, oh, the way that things have been. Oh, oh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of my sea. Oh, oh. The master of my sea, oh, oh. I was broken from a young age, taking my soaking to the masses, running my poems for the few that looked at me, took to me, shook to me, feeling me, singing heartache from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lessons from the brain, seeing the beauty through the pain. You made me a, you made me a believer, believer. Break me down, you build me up, believer, believer. Pain, I let the bullets fly, I let them rain. My life, my love, my drive, they came from pain. You made me a believer, believer. Third things third, send a prayer to the ones up above. All the hate that you've heard is turning to a dove, oh, ooh, your spirit up above, oh, ooh. I was choking in the crowd, living my brain up in the cloud, falling like ashes to the ground, hoping my feelings they would drown, but they never did ever live, ebbing and flowing and hidden and limited, till it broke up in a rain down, it rained down like pain. You made me out, you made me out, believer. The grace of the fire in the flames. You're the face of the future, the blood in my veins. Oh, oh, the blood in my veins. Oh, oh. But they never would ever lift up and flowing and hip it in the minute till it broke up and it rain down. It rain down like pain. You made me out, you made me a believer. Believer, pain, you break me
Strawberry Fields. All right, where are we here? Oh, the 18-wheelers. Oh boy, they just keep coming, right? They just keep coming. Just when you thought you had heard the best, the next one comes and you're like, wow, they're good too. Don't get spoiled though. Don't be like those Patriot fans, those spoiled Patriot fans where they just, championships just keep coming. You know, like appreciate the greatness that is up here. Keep reminding yourself, these are high school kids, man. This is just ridiculous. All right, if you remember the 18-wheelers, they sang different their first time up. They're singing Dancing on My Own, which is a song by Robin. I researched it today, by Robin, which is my mom's name, so I don't think it's my mom. She's not a good singer either. She's a good woman too, though. Dancing on My Own by Robin, and they're ready. Here they come, the 18-wheelers.
Just take you to say goodbye.
watching you kiss her. Whoa.
Suspenders. My wife said don't wear suspenders with the beard, it's too much, but I think I could pull it off. Here we go. Pitch pipes are back. Pitch pipes! Where are they? Lexington High's pitch pipes. They sang You Found Me last time through. This time they're going to sing Black and Gold, which I don't really know much about, but Ava just inhaled deeply, so it must be a really cool song. Black and Gold by the Pitch Pipes. Are they here? They're coming. Here they come.
Fish swam out of the ocean and grew legs and they started walking. And the apes climbed down from the trees and grew tall and they started talking. And the stars fell out of the sky and my tears rolled into the ocean. Now I'm looking for a reason why you even set my world into motion. Cause if you're not really here, then the stars don't even matter. Now I feel to the top with fear that it's all just a bunch of matter. Cause if you're not really here, then I don't wanna be either. Wanna be next to you. Black and gold, black and gold, black and gold. I look up into the night sky. I see a thousand miles turn back. And all around these golden beacons, I see nothing but black. I feel the weight of something beyond, and I don't see what I can feel. The vision is the only validation. Most of my life isn't real.
You are not, you are not, but up here, but up then. The stars, but up now, I'm filled to the top, top with that fear, but up, fear, to the top with fear, now I'm filled to the, oh, you're not really here,
I know I'm not worthy to be a judge, but that was the best snapping I've ever heard in my life. That was on point every time. We have two groups left. This is getting very serious. The next group is KO's Finest, Crimson Seven. It's our all-boys group, if you remember them. They, too, are a good-looking group of boys. They're gonna sing a Nina Simone song. And you know how you have like that one person, that one group, that one musical artist that you just have a relationship with? For me, that is Nina Simone. So boys, let's do it.
It's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
You know how I feel. Sons of the pine, you know how I feel. Oh, freedom is mine, and I know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. A new life for me. And I'm
Seven! Yeah! High school girls in the audience, that's Matt Moratolo, and I can hook you up with this number if you want me to. Just say the word! I can get it for you. Didn't his voice just like crawl in your chest and just sit there? That was awesome. Alright, we're to our last group, sadly. I know, you don't want it to end. I know you don't want it to end. So they're B sharp. It's Rory's group. You know, Rory's got the referee mom, right? Isn't that awesome? Like, his mom is a basketball referee. You know what my mom did when I was in high school? Nagged me all the time. That's it. It was just her job. But Rory's mom has another job. She refs basketball. So that's awesome. B sharp, final song of the night. They are going to do Believer. Okay, it's a Believer off right now by Imagine Dragons. So here they come.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that
believer.
Sharp. Pretty impressive, B Sharp. That's the end. That's the end of the presentations, okay? That's the presentations. That's the singing. Now it's the hard part. Now those judges over there, they gotta make some decisions. Good luck. Good luck to them. So a couple shout outs while the judges crunch their numbers. So we mentioned earlier the heroes, the real heroes, the teachers. And I want to say some specific names so that you can honor them. The inventor of this whole night is here tonight. He's a former KO teacher, music teacher. His name's Marcos Carreras. Where are you, Marcos? He has a ponytail now. He didn't have that back then. He's got a ponytail. He invented this night 10 years ago. This is his baby. So he's here watching his baby come to fruition. I'm sure he's very teary-eyed over there. So Marcos, well done. The music teachers here that put this all together, David Baker, Todd Millen, Stevie Mitchell, you guys are amazing. Juan Martinez, yeah. Juan Martinez and Dan and all his boys in the tech department who are live streaming this to zillions across the globe. You did great. Ron Garcia, the aforementioned Ron Garcia, told me that it's upwards of $13,000 that we raised tonight for Toba Kid. Right? That's no chump change. So that's because of all of you. So congratulate yourselves, you're doing great too. So we are going to have a performance by some professionals. First we're gonna excuse the judges, there they go, look at them. Look at them judging. Judging. How'd you get that gig, judge? I wanna be a judge. I can judge. Juan, you're doing great. See, I'm judging. Great job, Juan. We're going to have some professionals, right? Phoebe, are the professionals here? The professionals are here. And my notes are down there, some stuff about them, but I'll give it to you afterwards. It's a Yukon group, I know that. Are there any Yukon Huskies in the audience? Fellow alums? Yeah. Right? It's a great school. So we're going to see how the professionals do it, okay? These are not high school kids. I think they're in college. Which is what you found it. So let's hear it for the pros.
Time when I'm not beside you, I'm moving on. No, I don't cry. see tears in my eyes about you. Gonna be fine if I die without you, baby, I'm gone. In the words that I tell myself enough.
Jessica. I'm the music director for A Minor, UConn's oldest co-ed a cappella group. And we are so excited to be here for the third time performing. Thank you so much to Kayla for inviting us. We are blown away by all the talented groups here every year. And we hope we can continue to do this for many years to come. We actually have an alum of KO in our group, Narina. And our last soloist, Emma, used to be in one of the groups that competed here earlier. So we're really excited to be back. And we hope that if you like what you hear, you'll check us out on social media, on all forms of social media, at UConn A Minor. And we also have an album on Spotify and Apple Music, and we hope that you'll check us out there. It's called Ignite. So we have a few more songs for you, and we hope you enjoy. Thank you so much.
Around for hours. infested with villains that live in my bed. They beg me to write them so they'll never die when I'm dead. And I've grown familiar with villains that live in my head. They beg me to write them so I'll never die when I'm dead. I'm bigger than my body.
You got me in chains. You got me in chains for your love, but I wouldn't change. No, I wouldn't change this love. Trying to break the chains, but the chains only break.
Do a beatbox challenge. Is that happening? Are you gonna do that for us? Yeah, all right, perfect. Do that.
All right. How's everyone doing tonight? That's good to hear. All right, y'all ready to hear a beatbox battle? I said, are y'all ready to hear a beatbox battle? There we go. Okay, so we have three, possibly four, of the best beatboxers in the world that are going to come up here and grace us with their tasty beats. All right, let's bring them out. Come on up. This is Jack from Fairfield. And as a beatboxer, you need something which is really important, a beatbox name. That's by far the most important thing. So Jack, what's your beatbox name?
Hoagie One Kenobi.
Hoagie One Kenobi. All right, let's see what you got, Jack.
Wow.
pretty cool, huh? Alright, now we've got Jeremy. It sounds like Jeremy has some friends here. Alright, Jeremy, what's your beatbox name?
My beatbox name is Meme.
Alright, let's see what you got. Rory, what's your beatbox name?
Rookie.
Rookie. Why is your beatbox name Rookie?
It's a long story.
Okay, all right, we're not gonna get into it. Let's hear your tasty beats.
Tasty's a loose word.
What's your beatbox name?
My beatbox name?
Yes.
It's called Wet Mike. This thing is
oh, okay.
So moist, it's disgusting.
Oh boy. Alright, let's hear your beats. I'm hoping we can get him on the board, but if we can't, it's alright. Zach, what is your beatbox name?
Boots and Dogs.
Boots and Dogs. Whoa! Alright, let's hear your beats. Wow! That's pretty awesome! So now we have to decide who is the Wyoth beatbox champion of 2018. And instead of just shouting out names, we're gonna put up on the screen a voting thing. A vote, oh, there we go. We've already had that many votes? That's a good thing, wow. All right, and you can text the code. Text a code to 22333 and vote on who you think. Oh, you text that code. Oh, that makes sense. Okay. Now I got it. All right. So text the code and you can vote who you think won. And while you text, they're going to do a second round. Here is Jack from Fairfield, Ludlow.
Do magic, so. All right.
Beatboxing, but I don't think I've ever seen magic and beatboxing at the same time. That's definitely a first. All right, and it looks like Guacamole Lexington High School has won. So congratulations. And I believe now it's time to announce the awards. So I'm gonna get off stage along with these wonderful gentlemen. Have a great night.
No big deal, I have the results right here. No big deal. No big deal. I am a big deal, sorry. Before I get to those, we have pieces of leather to give out. Real leather, okay? These are a special thanks to some special people. The first one is this man standing right behind me, Todd Millen, for all his work organizing this. And the second one is for the Godfather. Come on, Marcos. Come on up and get your leather, man. The Godfather of the YF, Marcos Carreras. Come on, old man. You can get up here. You got this. That's a legend. Come on. Come on. All right. Now for some more awards, some more leather to hand out. We're gonna get right into it. Best female soloist. Here we go. Anelga Hajar from Paramatapia. Come on up. Come on up. Make a path for Anelga. That's awesome. Deserve it. Learned it. All right. Best male soloist. That's right, ladies. Matthew Moratola. Yes. 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 Settle down, settle down. All right, best student arrangement. Josh Feldman from the Pitch Pipes. Yeah, Josh. Here he comes, here he comes. Take your time, Josh. Take your time, buddy. Take your time. You earned it, Josh. Good work. All right, best vocal percussion. Our boy Jeremy. Yes. Yes. All right, best choreography. Strawberry Fields for Believer. Send one person up, Strawberry Fields. Who you got? Who you got? Send one person up. Send your favorite. Send the nicest one up. All right. That's awesome. You deserve it. You deserve it. All right. Best student director. This is Sophia Lamba, and Keely Duran from the Grapes. You should all come up. All three of you, come up. Come on. Sophia, Adela, Keely, let's go. Let's go. Let the girl through. Let her through. Sophia, right? Sophia. Awesome. All right. Here we go. All right. Winners, please, like I said, just send up one. We don't want a whole storm of you up here, okay? Just one at a time. We're going to start with honorable mention, okay? Look at how quiet it just got. People are getting serious. We're going to start with honorable mention. And everybody's getting an honorable mention here. You guys were amazing. We all loved it. It was awesome. All that. Ridiculous. But the honorable mention, as voted by our precious judges, was Pitch Pipes. Come on up. Someone from the Pitch Pipes. Where are they? There he is. Yep, there he is. Congratulations, Pitch Pipes. That's so awesome. That is awesome. All right. Here goes bronze. Bronze, Close Harmony. Come on up. Where are they? Close Harmony. Not too close. Here he comes. Here he comes. Is this him? He looks like he's coming for the Price is Right. Come on down. Close Harmony. Yes. Made it. All right, silver. Our very own Cribs and Seven. Yes. Way to go, Cribs and Seven. All right, last but not least, our champion, Onomatopoeia. Come on. You guys can all come up. You can all come up, Onomatopoeia, if you want to. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come up here. How often do you win the YF? Right? Once a year. Let's go. Come up here. Yeah. That's beautiful. That's awesome. That's awesome. Congratulations. John B. All right, everybody. That's the end, right, Todd? They go home? They go home. You go home. All right. Great job, everybody.
Forgive me, I was lost in doubt. I wouldn't never let me say, pick me up when I thought I would die. You held me, and I was found. Lord knows you can't trust your head. Two footprints in the sand.